Honorable Chairman, sir, I thank you for this opportunity given to me to speak on this important bill, the Prasar Bharati Amendment Bill 2010. Sir, I have this predicament of speaking on this bill in the midst of an intervention by the Honorable Finance Minister on a very hot topic, it is the price rise and everything. So this bill, to my mind, is a very important bill, because here we are referring to, we are discussing an institution, the Prasar Bharati, which caters to the needs of millions and millions of Indians, especially those residing in the remotest corner of this country. So we are living in an age of information. It's called an information age. And now this information age, its name has been slightly modified, and now it is called the infotainment age, meaning thereby that we have to cater to the needs of people to provide them with quick and authentic information, and also to provide them healthy and wholesome entertainment. This Prasar Bharati as an institution is a government-owned institution. It runs on public money. It has this primary responsibility to be of some use for the people of this country, especially the poor and deprived people. So in this age of information, besides this TV and radio, we have many other means and ways of disseminating information, like print media, radio, internet. And out of these four institutions, four mechanisms, the television, which in this age you will find in even the remotest corners of the country, in the house of a poor man also, in the heart of a poor man also, it plays the most important part of disseminating information and providing wholesome entertainment. But what we see today, sir, in the name of information or in the name of entertainment in our country, what we are being given, what our people are being provided, is vulgar display of human body, bogus information, concocted facts. And here I'm referring to not just the private media, but the government media, that is the Prasar Bharati, has also its share of omissions and commissions. Since this bill refers to the Prasar Bharati, I'll focus on certain points which I think are very valuable, very important from the point of view of the common man who is away from cities, who's away from small cities, who's living in the remotest corner of the country. The Prasar Bharati is passing through a very big crisis. Sir, to my mind, any media, whether it's print media or any other media, audiovisual media, it requires two things, two important parameters to make it run in the longer run. One is quality, and the second one is credibility. Without these two legs, you cannot go too far. And in terms of quality and credibility, where do we stand? Especially from the point of view of this TV channels and everything, whether government owned or private owned. First, I will talk about the private media. The kind of vulgarity which we are seeing on private TV channels, I don't think I need to explain much on that, because every day we are seeing this thing. Many of the distinguished speakers before me, they have highlighted this fact that in the name of entertainment, what rubbish is going. At the same time, sir, I hope we all agree that all of us, not just as members of parliament, honorable members of parliament, but also as individuals who have seen this institution of Prasar Bharati, TV and radio, graduating from black and white era to modern day color era. Earlier we used to have one or two channels, and today we see hundreds and hundreds of channels bombarding our television set. Technology wise, our growth has been exponential. In terms of viewership, we have grown manifold. But sadly, in terms of quality, we have only fallen down. Our level has gone down and down and down. This is the pathetic scenario that we as a country and we as a society, and we, the honorable members of this house, as viewers also, we have experienced in our daily life. What is the reason of it, and what is the solution? Many years back, the radio and television employees, they were put into this Prasar Bharati category. For 10, 12, 15 years it ran, and today we have reached this stage where again we are thinking of, as Mr. Iyer said, the so-called course correction. I don't understand what is the meaning of course correction in this. You may use any word for this. The moot point is, the central point is, that as a government institution, Prasar Bharati has failed to fulfill its duty. The number of employees, the shortfall of personnel to run this institution. Even in Prasar Bharati, even if you talk of DD also, there are scores of channels catering to regional centers, and in the center also, there are so many channels are there. I'll compare the quality of program, say in Discovery channels or History channel or Fox channel. See the quality of programs, the way they marry information and entertainment. Similarly, in All India Radio and DD also. DD has been existing for the last 50 years. All India Radio has been there for the last 100 years or so. There was such a rich repository of software, our old singers, intellectuals, leaders, their interviews, programs of the 80s, 70s. But DD is not making use of them. What you see, the same rubbish which is shown on private channels, the same kind of rubbish is, we have Saas Bahu channels. In private channels, the same Saas Bahu comes on DD also. You find a serial, successful serial in private channel, the same kind of serial is produced by DD also. There is no application of mind, no creativity. Of course, there is a problem of this DD acting as the spokesperson for the government, the party in power. But why it is happening, sir? We don't give opportunity to our people, the employees of All India Radio or DD, we don't give them creative freedom. We know what kind of corruption is there. We all know about it. How the programs are commissioned. They are commissioned on the basis of commission. And then there is a question of mismanagement. How things are mismanaged in Prasar Bharati, DD and All India Radio, I need not repeat it here. But one important point I want to highlight here, sir. Now, many of the speakers, distinguished members, they have talked of this 12,000 shortfall. Sir, if we go into the details, this 12,000 means the backlog quota of SC/ST and OBC, which has not been filled for the last so many years. And this is not the story of Prasar Bharati only. You go to any department, you will find that this kind of situation is there. The people are being denied opportunity to work there. People who have got connection, they get recruited there. SC/ST OBC quota has not been filled for so many years. It is keeps on accumulating, and the government pays no attention. The question is, unless we change our mindsets, the situation is not going to improve. I'll give another example, sir.
Please conclude.
Yeah, just 2 minutes, sir. DD Doordarshan is running, it was running, Urdu channel some time back, and 2-3 months back it has been closed down. Now DD Urdu was catering to a segment of society, and Urdu is a very rich language. I have yet to understand why it has been closed down, and many members of honourable members of parliament, they have written to the Prime Minister also, and I am sure they have written to the Minister, honourable Minister also, but nothing has been done. I wish to highlight one point which Mr. Iyer said, he is not here, and I was very surprised at that. I am talking of the filling up of backlog to fill this 12,000 posts so that it can work more efficiently, and somehow for reasons known to him, best known to him, Mr. Iyer has suggested to make our honourable ministers jobless. He said there is no need for this ministry. If there is no ministry, means no minister. So I don't know whether honourable minister agrees with him or don't. She agrees.
Don't agree.
We appeal to you to not agree to him.
Please.
Because you cannot compare Doordarshan with any other thing like BBC or Fox News or some American or European channels. We have to understand the ground realities in our country. Our Doordarshan caters to a class of people who are not covered by this so-called channel. Their need of information and entertainment, they are not covered by this private channel. So sir, anyway, that's for the minister and for the government to decide whether they want to wind up or not wind up. But sir, the central point in I'll just wind it up, sir. Unless you fill up this backlog position, you got to run any institution, you need people. When there are no people, naturally there won't be efficiency. So the starting point for this thing is that we must fill up this post, and I request the minister, honorable minister who is here fortunately, to please look into this fact of how fast you can fill up this backlog quota for SCST and OBCs. And I can assure you the SCST OBC people are, they are not short of talent, especially creative talent. So I hope you will consider this sympathetically, and with this I thank you, sir, again for giving me this opportunity.
Thank you.
To speak on this important topic, important bill. Thank you very much, sir.